After knocking out Edgewater in the second round, Lake Brantley would host Jacksonville Sandalwood for the Region 1 championship. The Patriots had never advanced to the state semifinals. The first half for the Patriots would be full of missed opportunities. Lake Brantley got inside Sandalwood territory on each of its first five possessions, but could not capitalize. The first four drives resulted in two punts and two fumbles. But the Patriot defense locked down the Saints. Lake Brantley forced Sandalwood to punt three times, and Mike Davis intercepted Saints quarterback Albert Nevins on its fourth possession. With time running out in the half, Lake Brantley faced a fourth and goal and decided to go for the touchdown.
And it's DeMarco that's in there at quarterback. He takes the snap to the left side. DeMarco is hit and denied a yard out. And again, Brantley misses an opportunity to score.
The Patriots had seemingly dominated the first half of play, but the game was still scoreless at the break. After a procedure penalty backed the Patriots up 5 yards on the kickoff to begin the second half, Lake Brantley decided to utilize the accurate foot of kicker Dale Brenchley.
Brenchley's kick is short to the far side of the field. It's loose. It's recovered by Brantley. Recovered by Lake Brantley at the 37-yard line, and Mitch McGrath.
On this drive, the Patriots would not be denied.
Randolph under center. There's the snap. He fakes. Option to the far side. Randolph inside the 30, inside the 25. Randolph takes the snap. It's Miles straight ahead. Lowers his shoulder and breaks the tackle. Miles inside the 15. He'll have first and goal for Lake Brantley at the Sandalwood 7. Randolph takes the snap. Good backfield penetration. Randolph fakes to Miles, keeps it himself, and scores. Touchdown, Lake Brantley. Carl Randolph, the senior, with a 6-yard touchdown run.
Brinchley's extra point gave Lake Brantley a 7-0 lead early in the third quarter. The Patriot defense continued to dominate, but just as Sandalwood's defense appeared to be figuring out Brantley's triple option, Antonio Miles broke a big run to get his team inside the Saints' 35-yard line. Carl Randolph then hit Rhett Hamrick to get inside the 20-yard line. Then, unable to get into the end zone, the Patriots lined up for a field goal.
McGrath will hold, snap is good, hold is down, kick is on the way from Brenchley, and it's through. 32-yarder splits the uprights. That gives Brantley a 2-possession lead.
Sandalwood, now on its 8th possession of the game, had yet to make any real progress offensively. And with nothing to lose, the Saints gambled on 4th down.
Dixon standing back at his own 30-yard line. It's a fake. Running free at the 45. Inside the 40. This could be a touchdown. Inside the 30. DeMarco tries to make a play. Touchdown, Sandalwood. Marquise Boone. 56 yards.
Now the Saints had seized momentum and trailed 10-7 at the end of the third quarter. Sandalwood's defensive pressure picked up and created havoc in the Brantley backfield. And with just minutes remaining, Sandalwood got the big play they needed.
Randolph takes the snap, wants to throw, and it's intercepted at the 45. Return is on at the 40, inside the 30 of Lake Brantley, and out of bounds at the 25-yard line.
But Lake Brantley's defense again rose to the occasion, forcing Sandalwood to attempt a field goal.
Under 2 minutes to play, 34-yard attempt for junior Josh Kemp to tie the game. Dixon will hold. Snap is good. Hold is down. Kick is on the way from Kemp, and he missed it wide to the right. With 1:41 remaining, Brantley takes over following the missed field goal.
Lake Brantley was unable to run out the clock and was forced to punt with 1 minute and 11 seconds left in the game. Sandalwood advanced the ball to midfield but faced a fourth down with less than 30 seconds to go.
Nevins is in the shotgun. He takes the snap and drops. DeMarco comes free. DeMarco brings him down at the 37. Brantley's going to win. The Patriots will advance to the state semifinals for the first time in school history. For the second straight week, Pat DeMarco ends the team's hopes with a quarterback sack. And the Brantley students pour onto the field to celebrate with their heroes.